Right, let's get this show on the road. I just need all that. And we should be off. This is Super Mario 64. I'm gonna quickly check. Yep, all that looks fine. Right. Okay, so when we last left off in this game, we were on about 50, roughly 50 stars. And, yeah, we're getting close to, oh, we're actually on about 60 stars. Well, there we go then. I believe we need about 70 to get to Bowser. So it's probably about time we went and did that. So yes, this has been quite a fun game to stream. I've obviously, like I said, played it a lot of times, but, Mario 64 really is a super fun game, and, yeah, right. And, like, it's been a while since I've done a casual playthrough of it. But we're almost now at the end. So, let's-a go. Which stages do we have to do? Right, TikTok clock, we have some missions we haven't done. Let's go do those. Bomb on the thwomp. Okay, good, I haven't frozen time. I still don't know how to freeze time in this place, but I guess we're going to find out. Nope. Oh, no, no. Well, we're off to a very good start on this stream, I'll give you that. Mamma mia. Well, there we go. So, with TikTok clock, as I mentioned the other day, there are a few missions that like require you to have stopped the time. This is not one of those missions. You need the time going for this one, which considering I can't remember how to access each different like time setting, could be annoying. But oh well, we've got time moving right now, so let's run with that. As I've said, this is intended to be the last stream for Mario 64. On the next stream, I'll be playing something different. I've managed to actually get the Kega Fusion Sega Mega Drive emulator now running with OBS properly, so I'll be able to stream stuff like Sonic, although I might not, because Sonic games like Sonic don't typically look good on stream, because Twitch's bitrate limit is like 3,500. And Sonic does not look good at that, because it's so fast. I don't know why, it doesn't. Just because 2 kind of have the same issue. Anyway, in this stage, I think the basic aim is just climb to the top of the place. Because that mission type hasn't been overdone. Okay. Making progress. Yeah. No, 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 no. Oh. Weird. Alright, we did that well. I think we're almost at the top. And let's dodge that thing. Right now, I just gotta wait for this clock hand to take us over again. So, what shall we discuss? Let's discuss Sonic again. Anyway, for those who have been watching the stream, you may notice there is now a snazzy green hill zone background. Yeah, but it's just a test. I'll probably replace it with something that's not so. Well, I've dimmed the brightness on it, so it's not eye bleeding. But you know, if I do stream Sonic, it'll be helpful to get rid of that. So we'll find out. Suppose. And there we go, Stomp on the Thwomp is done. So now we're only 10 stars away from fighting Bowser. I'll probably get a few extra stars, maybe mop up the course as I haven't done. I might go back to Hazy Maze Cave, because otherwise this stream's probably like, going to be over quite quickly, actually. So, timed jumps on the moving bars. I think I know what this one wants me to do. Up we go. Right, we're almost at the top. Oh, the bit where we need to be, I think. Please. Why not? I know there's a mission that has you fall into a cage and stuff like that. It's called Fall Into the Cage, or that might only be in the DS version, but... Well, we'll find out. Oh, that was close. That was... Oh, here we go. These look like moving bars that we have to time jumps on. If the camera decides to stop having an aneurysm. Hey, there we go. Here we go. So, as for what's next, stop time for red coins. We've done that well because I haven't stopped time. So, I'm going to go do a different mission instead. I think there's another mission I can do without getting hamper. Truth be told, the red coin mission on this course isn't actually too hard. It's just, I need to stop time for it. I haven't stopped time. But oh well, I do think there is another one we can do instead. Ow. No. Okay then. Oh. Man, judging depth in this game, it's not my specialty. But I think that's a pretty common complaint, all things considered. Let's continue further on up. Pretty sure there is. Up here. Whoa. Whoa. Let's not do that again. Right. Is it that? Please be that. Oh, I feel like this is just gonna be coins, isn't it? Of course it is. Why did I think there was another star up here then? Or am I just forgetting something else? Well, I guess we're gonna find out because the moment at the top. Yeah, I think I might have screwed this over. I didn't mean to do that though. I might as well kill myself now because can't exactly do the red coins. Geronimo! Right. Bear with me while I go and look up what the hell I'm actually supposed to do here, because I know you have to wait for, I think, the minute hand to stop on one of the things, but I'm not sure of the specifics. So I'll go find out the specifics, and then, yeah. Magic will happen. Right, 3064, stopping time. Right, when the arm points to 12, apparently. Well, let's try that then. There we go. And lo and behold, everything is stopped. But now I can actually do this. Whoa, no. Did that well. Try again. Again, this is not a very hard mission. That's the exact opposite. Now I just have to go over there and collect our star. And... oh, damn it, Mario. Ugh. Jump. Oh, damn. Why is this so awkward? I do know what level we're going to next, at least. It's not Rainbow Ride, because... next up, I'm probably gonna do the desert level. What's it called? Dusty Desert? No, that's Sonic, probably. I don't even know anymore. Point is, we're going to go and do the desert level. Let's go do the desert level. Nice. The chat is not as active today. My heart is broken. Yeah, kick down the stairs, because why not? And down we go. Right then, desert level, desert level. Then I might as well just finish Hazy Maze Cave. And then I just remembered I'm up to the 8 red coins mission on Hazy Maze Cave, so yeah, screw that plan. Oh, hang on, this guy might have enough star, I'm not sure. I know that at some point this guy gets another star. I just can't remember when. Damn it. Because we all know how much I enjoyed chasing the tall, tall mountain monkey, here's more of me chasing. Trying to grab them. Ow. And that happening. Again. Get off, though. Well done, me. Oh, come on, I usually catch him down there. Oh, come on. Dash. Oh. Oh. This camera is not ideal for catching rabbits in an enclosed area. Oh. Right, fuck this. I'll get him later or something. We have more pressing matters like, you know, popping Bowser. Oh, come on. I had him. Shit. Right, anyway, the first mission of the desert is in the talons of the big bird. So let's go visit a big bird, give him the bird. By taking his star. Okay, I thought we made a mistake for a second there. Ah yes, the tox boxes. These things are freaking weird. But there was a very fun tox box minigame in Mario... whatchamacallit. Hang on. Hey, a cannon. In Mario 64 DS, there was a very fun tox box matching minigame. That thing was my jam. Right, okay. Here we go. Oh, wait a second. There he is. Yeah. Oh, now that bird wants to steal our hats. Let's not let him do that. Here we go! So, second mission is... shining atop the pyramid. Let's go find whatever the hell is shining atop the pyramid. Even though it's, you know, fairly obvious. Oh, come on. Let me just quickly spin the camera. And then... one, two, three. Hey, look at that. Like a pro. And so, we take to the skies as Wing Mario. Wing Cap Mario. The one with the wing. And so we fall down as Wing Cap Mario. Let's not do that. Let's let that goddamn star. It's right in front of us. There we go. Right then, back in we go. Inside the ancient pyramid. Here comes fun. Right. Just a moment. Right then, sorry about that. Let's get back to business. Mario business. Let me see. Into the ancient pyramid. Wow, this place is a bit darker than I remember. Not to worry. And not do that. Upwards we climb. And now we have to climb across this thing. Sadly, the climbing controls in this game are terrible compared to the likes of Crash Bandicoot 3. Because you can very, very, very easily fall off these ones, and in Hazy Maze Cave, that is torture. Oof. Well, Mario has been rendered a pancake, but let's not let that worry us. No. Why do these things keep happening to me? Not to worry, we can get back up. I think. Stop falling in shit. Give it a sec. Right, oh, we're gold. Let's go. I hate doing this. This particular bit is just annoying. Because it's so slow. I mean, you can probably skip it, but... screw it. Right. Onwards we go. Oh. We're not very good at dodging that thing. That's becoming a recurring theme. Not to worry though, there's life there. I should have grabbed that coin, whatever. Up we go! Annoying electricity, guys. And we are up. Right, let's not fall this time. Wouldn't that be a great idea? That was a bit too close for comfort. And so there we go, we have the pyramid's treasure, and unsurprisingly it's a, whatchamacallit, star. Right then, continuing on, we have, what is next actually, I can't remember. Stand tall on the four pillars. This one was a pain in the ass when I was young. But let's get on with it, because we're getting closer and closer to Bowser. No, get go, let's use the tried and tested method of, wing cap. Actually, I think you might be able to use the, shell for this, but I would not be arsed trying it. So let's just do it the normal way. Go. Right then, onwards. Well, this is going a lot better than I remember it going on the DS version when I was little, so, there's that. Hey, look at that. When I first saw that, my mind was blown. So, down we go. Here we go, into this one bit that we couldn't access earlier. Well, nothing weird about this picture. Let's just go and- oh shit. So, this is I-Rock, who appeared in this game, the DS remake, and Mario Kart DS for some reason. Maybe something else. I'm probably forgetting about. He's mercifully easy. They already dead. And condemnerific. Okay, we have another one. Did I just jump into a painting with a red coin mission? Of course I did. There is, one more mission inside the pyramid, but actually it's more annoying than the, red coins. It's another one of those, find the five secrets ones, and it's infuriating, so... You know what, for once, let's be thankful for a red coin mission. Let's just do the red coin mission. Dive. Do a... backflip. Technically, I could just go to Bowser now because infinite stir trick, but for one, I'm not sure I could actually do it on a Xbox pad. And so, I'll be arsed. Let's do this as legitimately as possible. You know, I haven't actually used any cheats or anything, obviously, so. Let's just do this legit. Who needs glitches? We are real Mario players. I'm going to go refill my wing power. Evidently, no, I'm not. There is a red coin down here, I believe. On this very narrow patch of land. Okay, we're gold. That wing texture is strangely high quality. I know I have a bunch of filters on in the settings, but even then. Is there anything in that direction? No, not from those things. Oh, I know where the next one is. In that weird pond over there. We're off, bird. Nobody likes you. Oh, don't do that. Yeah, this Xbox pad's right analog stick ain't exactly great for C-stick buttons. I'm drawing a blank for this last one. I think I've got all the ones in the sky. One way to find out. Time for yet another flyover. And it's just over the... Well done, mate. Well... Okay, it's in this box, isn't it? There we go. Right, for reasons I've already mentioned, I'm not going to bother with the last star of this course. Gonna move straight onto the well, don't know which level I'm going. Let's go Wet and Dry World. I've not visited that world at all yet. Right then, onwards to that place that I just mentioned. First of all, let's see if I can just fucking... Yes, I actually got him. There we go. Here we go. Ain't this going swimmingly? Right, we now apparently, well, from the looks things, we need two more stars. Wow, only two. That was. Well, let's head up there, because might as well. And, Wet and Dry World. Actually, no, I'm going to do a Tiny Huge Island instead, because I've already pretty much finished that place. And the last missions are quite fun, actually. Because there is actually a boss fight among them. Yeah, let's go do that. When in doubt, go in the tiny painting. Fake Wigglet Squirm. For friggin' ages, I had no idea what to do on this one. I knew Wiggler was somewhere, like, cave. I just didn't know, like, what the hell to do to have him fight on. And then, practically by complete accident, I discovered. And that was stupid, and... It's another example of this game having abysmal conveyance. Nintendo 64 games, I found, had a lot of that, actually, because I'm also one of the camp that thinks... yeah, that's what you're supposed to do. That. Real obvious. I'm of the camp that thinks, Zelda Ocarina of Time isn't amazing. Go me! Look at me, I'm unique! I'm not. But, oh well, let's backflip. Right. Solid. Now let's just get up to, here, and up here. So, down we go. So, now, Wiglet is soaked, and we laugh at his misfortune. Oh, Wiglet. I think you just jump on his head. Ground pound it. Now he just jump on it. Now he's really mad. At this point in the at this point in the DS version, he becomes the Red Wiggler from the Super Mario World and everything. So we beat him, and suddenly he's okay with us. And also he turns tiny, and as we'll see in a second, he says this is his house, and despite it being his house, he just falls through the floor. But yeah, with that, we only need one more star from the paintings, and then we're golden. And as for where we're going for that, I mean, I could do... I haven't finished Cool Cool Mountain. Yes, I thought I had. Let's go do that one then. Oh wait, it's Snowman's big head, isn't it? Fine, let's end this bombastically. We're going to go and do Snowman's Big Head, my most hated mission in this entire game. From how weirdly specific it is. Down we go. And that was a skid. Or we could do a 100 coin mission. To round everything off. I wouldn't subject anybody to that. Right, Snowman's lost his head. This one is a pain in the ass, but all of the pain in the ass. Don't know where I was going with that, but whatever. Why does he take off immediately? Let me show you where to go. Damn snowman. Oh, fuck. No, stop. Where are you going? Oh. Oh hey, some memories. Good to have you here. Let me see. Big Boo's Haunt. We can probably do that one, yeah. Yeah, let's go do Big Boo's Haunt, round everything off, and then... Again, I might actually leave Bowser for a bit, maybe complete another level, just because... This stream is going to be over very quickly if we just go and do, thingy right now. We just go do, or I could stream another game, you know. But yeah, I could go do Bowser in a moment, so whatever. Right, on account of the fact I do not care for the merry-go-round mission because it'd be a very anticlimactic, final level, let's go do, Big Boo. The hard part of this isn't even fighting Big Bo. Oh, that was easier. Now for the hard part. I can never ever remember how the hell to get up here. Hope for the best. Well, that went easier than I expected. This edge. Ooh. Jesus Christ, that was the easiest I've ever done that. Nice one, mate. And so, we now have 70 power stars. That's enough to go fight Bowser. Save and continue. 70 power stars. So, we can go to the final battle now. I am stuck now between actually going and beating Bowser and then moving on to a different game, or doing some more stages first. Do we have any thoughts on this from the chat? In fact, before all that, I'm going to try and do this. This is stressful. Yes, we did it. In terms of other games, I'm probably thinking just along the lines of... Ooh, damn, that was close. Of something on the Mega Drive. I'd consider something like Rystar, or... because I haven't actually properly played Rystar before. I've played it, I've just not gotten very far in it. So, I'd consider that, but other than that, Sonic, probably. Probably Sonic 1 or 3. I don't like Sonic 2. But I don't know. We'll see. I'm just glad I managed to get the Mega Drive emulator working. Right, am I enough dilly-dallying? I'm gonna head up anyway. Because, yeah. Right then, that's pretty much that decided then. I'm going to stream Rystar after this and see how far I can get in it before I give up. Because, I've never actually played it much. For the emulation, I'm just using Kega Fusion. I have a... What it is, you can do layered window capture and in OBS, and that apparently works. Look, I know we've solved the stairs, but screw it, we do it anyway, because it's like it's tradition. Nice, let me see. This tradition is going badly. Damn it, this usually goes fine. Ah, screw it, we don't need to do this. Right, anyway, if everything goes well then, after this I shall stream Rystar. Let's find out. To the final bout with Bowser we go. Because, God knows how long this will take me, actually. If I do stream Rystar, it won't be a very... Oh, shit, it won't be a very long stream. It'll probably only be till, like, what, 10 o'clock BST. But, let's go beat Mario 64. In terms of Rystar, I haven't actually played the thing in years. Like, I played it once on a Mega Drive collection, and then pretty much never again. And I only beat like the very first level. So, yeah, it's going to be interesting because I mean I don't suck as much at games anymore. So maybe I'll actually get decent in it, or maybe I'll fail horribly. I fully expect the latter. Well, I guess it's more interesting than another Sonic live stream, even though I've not actually done any of those yet. For some reason, OBS freezes with Sonic Generations. Well, Sonic Generations freezes with OBS, and I don't know why that is. But, oh well. Up there. I was actually quite surprised when the window capture worked. I'm not 100% sure if it'll... I think it streams, but it definitely recorded correctly. So, that's basically just local streaming. So, it does look like Kega now works with OBS, which is good. Now, enough ranting on about that, because we're just about at the final battle. If I ever get that. Well done, mate. Let me just grab this one up. Gonna need that probably. Right then, on to the final Bowser fight. This thing is a pain in the ass. It's technically easy, but I just suck at aiming Bowser. One stream I might do in the future is I might do a Streets of Rage remake. I've been playing, oops, shit, I've been playing that tonight, and it's really, it's insanely good. I can't believe Sega cease and desisted the project. I can understand why they. Easy to assist it. I just wish they hadn't because it is insanely good. So long, Oh, come on, how did that not count as a hit? Even though he was technically way off. Bowser has seen better days in this game. Oh no. Throw him. Hey, we can refill our life. Damn it, I was supposed to grab his tail. Ish. Fire is everywhere. No, you bloody don't. Okay, come on, I can't possibly miss this. And I still completely missed it. Well done, me. I have to wait for him to actually get back on the platform so I can grab his tail. Whoa. Come on. Why am I so bad at these fights? Oh, what the hell was that? I like... Yeah. Oh. How the hell do I keep doing this? Oh, no, never mind. We did it. Don't give him a chance to recover. Just spin him round like crazy, lob him anywhere, I don't care anymore. Oh, we did that well. And over he goes. I cannot believe I just jumped over freaking Bowser. Well, he's certainly gone. God, why do the bombs have to be such small targets? Oh, I actually ran around him so fast he began to loop back around. I mean, it's in the right direction, kind of. Whoa! I actually got him. And he hit me. Oh, no. Come on, we can do this. Oh, come on! Stop jumping. Stop jumping! I swear to frigging Christ, if you don't stop jumping, ow! Jeez. Okay, come on. We've got this. We can't frigging lose. Ugh. Why won't he die? Okay, the bomb is literally right there. But you know what, I always throw them out of picture, so, and I never throw them straight ahead of me, so, do it like this. I like how that almost worked. Almost, but almost is better than completely. Ah, oh, no. Ugh. No, 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 no. No. Oh. How the hell did I balls out of? God damn, what is this, a Game Grumps outtake? Head back. Right, screw it, no more messing around, I just want to get this over and done with. This rate, there won't be time for a Rystar livestream. Well done. Whoa. Oh, I keep throwing him just after I intend to. That was so goddamn close. I feel very sorry for everybody watching right now. How is one person this bad at these boss fights? Oh, come on! Oh. I have never been this bad at this. Finally! Oh, come on! Who designed this stupid arena? Just die already. Oh, thank God for that. Ow. Ow. Please don't tell me I'm standing on a piece of the star. No, evidently not. Oh, come on. Oh, come on! Just a moment, putting frame limit on so that the fucking those were I wanted to. Ugh. Damn. Oh. In the DS version, you're spinning around with a, you know, you can use a D-pad, but it's recommended you use the touchscreen, which is pretty much the only good use for that thing in the DS version. Because, no, you can't use a DS stylus as an analog stick. Yes! Finally! And so, we just beat, technically, Super Mario 64. Bloody hell. Well, this has been a fun stream series to do, and that was my first. I think it's gone pretty damn well, all things considered. Thanks to all who watched it, and while a second ago I said I was going to do Rystar, a friend has just notified me that he is streaming something in a minute, and I'd actually quite like to watch that. So, tomorrow we shall return, most likely, with Rystar on the Sega Mega Drive. For now though, let's sit back and watch these credits with the best credits music ever, pretty much. I'm just going to sit here and jam to it. And so this has been Tracker TD Plays Super Mario 64. Thank you all for watching, and have a great evening.
Thank you so much for playing my game.